Well, of course, it's a sector network. So networking and meeting other colleagues is one of the big expectations I have of the next few days. But also learning about the different approaches that our colleagues have in terms of food systems transformation, hearing what's worked in terms of scaling, and also hearing where certain gaps are and where we can contribute with our project.
Yeah, I have three expectations. So one is, of course, the exchange. We have here potential. There are national, regional, and also international experts. Yeah. The second is that my project, we have a matching grant fund, and we are looking for good proposals. And we would like also to motivate the colleagues here in their countries to motivate partners to get for this fund, this matching grant fund from ABF. And last but not least, in the exchange with other projects, we are looking for integrated solutions. As you know, in the new GIZ strategy 23 to 27, we have this main goal also to create integrated solution for major challenges of this world. And this is a good moment now here.
Yeah, very specifically, what I also expect from the next few days is focusing on how to bring within the food systems transformation, how to bring the environmental aspects, ecosystem services, deforestation-free aspects, biodiversity into the debate, especially looking at the global politics at the moment with the EU Green Deal and other international movements, with the COP coming up in December. How can we bring all these different topics together?
Yeah, I like your ideas, Elke. I'm also here for this, no? But in addition, we have this matching grant fund from ABF, no? Where we are looking for the value chains, cocoa and livestock and also maize. We are looking for innovative ideas, yeah? And I hope that we get some input here and that a lot of colleagues afterwards will apply for this matching grant fund with the partners.
So one of the main aims for me over the next few days and how I see that I can contribute is bringing in the close work that we're doing with the European Commission on EU Green Deal policies, especially looking at the new EU deforestation regulation, which will have a big impact on the food systems transformation, not just in Africa, but across the globe. And yeah, how we can bring in all the debates that we have in our project with the EU Commission and other partners and localize it here.
Yes, and my project, Agribusiness Facility for Africa, we have a lot of experience in training farmers especially. So I would like to know more about what are at the moment the main topics for training, yeah, for farmers. Yeah, if we, for example, work with the Farmer Business School as an approach, if this needs some adjustments, if yes, how we should organize and so on.
And this is where I think a lot of synergies can happen at the sector network.
Exactly.
Between, for example, what you're doing and what we are doing, because there will be a big need for more trainings when this regulation comes into force on deforestation-free value chains. And we will need to work a lot more with smallholder farmers so that they're integrated in value chains. And without
Absolutely.
That, we
yes.
won't have a sustainable food system transformation. Mm-hmm. So. Mm-hmm. Already there are big synergies over the next few days.
Well summarized. Thank you.
Where would you think you would throw the money or focus on, not everything focus on, because you think that there's a great leverage point maybe, and why?
Also, I think training and again training, because this is a good investment, yeah. This enables farmers, in our case, for example, to produce better products, to do a better marketing, to get a higher income, yeah, to be also climate smart, no, in the production in future, yeah. So to find together with the farmers also overtraining integrated solutions for the challenges of this world, yeah, and I think this is what we should do. And that's why it's training and again training and training.
And to pick up from the word you mentioned, climate. So if I had a magic wand, I would really say we need to focus a lot more on ecosystems, integrated approaches in terms of thinking together, feminist development policies with climate, with food systems as one solution without thinking in different silos, which happens so often. So I think if we really want to address climate change, we need to think of all of this together. And so, yeah, I think for me, really climate smart approaches is very important.
This is true. Yes.